Okay guys, let's start the journey with the definition of accounting. What is accounting? Accounting is the language of business. It's an art and science as well to record all the business transactions. Accounting is the art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner. You must have knowledge about one thing, that accounting or accountancy begins where bookkeeping ends. That means you must have knowledge about the bookkeeping. Bookkeeping is an art through which all the business transactions are recorded according to principles in a regular and proper way, which is included right here. The word transaction. What are transactions? In accountancy, only those transactions are recorded which have got its monetary value. There are two types of transactions. First one is cash transaction, another one is credit transaction. Look, whenever the cash transaction takes place, the money will be involved right there directly. That means you are purchasing something, you are paying cash, you are selling something, you are receiving cash. That stands for cash transaction. That's why I have given an example over here, just like that. Bought furniture of rupees 1000 and paid cash. This stands for cash transaction. But whenever credit transaction takes place, you'll have to bear that person's name in your mind from whom you are transacting. Because whenever credit transaction takes place, the time lags took place. That means after 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, or after certain days, you'll have to pay or you'll have to receive the certain sum or certain money from a certain person. But in accountancy, one thing which you'll have to bear in your mind, that in accountancy only those transactions are recorded which has got its monetary value and also an event. What is that event? Event means a result. Just suppose an example I am giving right here. Ram promised to pay rupees 5000. Only he has promised, he hasn't executed his promise. In this transaction, we are not having any event. Only he has promised now. That's why it won't be recorded. There is no place such of such transaction in an accountancy. So these transactions will not be recorded in accountancy. Only those transactions can be recorded which has got its event, just like this. Bought furniture of rupees 1000 and paid cash. You have bought furniture and paid cash. That's an event. So it will be recorded. Now guys, the question arises how to record the transactions. All the transactions are recorded according to the principle followed by the double entry system. What is double entry system and who invented this? Actually, the father of double entry system, i.e. accountancy in a black and white mode, or as per the record says, it was Lucas Pacioli who invented double entry system in the year 1494. What does the double entry system stand for? Double entry system tells us that every transaction has two aspects. In accounting, one aspect is shown as debit, popularly known as DR, and other as credit, written as CR. What does debit and credit stand for? Debit means decrease in the value of equity or capital engaged. And credit stands for increase in the value of equity or capital. What are the rules of double entry system? You must have knowledge about that. For that, you've got to know basic golden rules of accountancy. And these basic golden rules are thoroughly based on the kinds of accounts. Mainly, to know these rules, you must have knowledge about the kinds of accounts right here as per these rules. Personal account and impersonal account, there are two types. Later on, impersonal account has been bifurcated into real account and nominal account. Let's discuss about personal account now. You can see, as per the name of this account, it's related with a person, a company, a firm, an organization, or an institution, etc. And the rule for personal account is debit the receiver and credit the giver. Just suppose, Ram paid rupees 200 to Shyam. Now you've got to know who is the receiver and who is the giver. Simply you can see. Shyam is receiving and Ram is the giver. Whenever you are going to record any transaction, at first you'll have to show debit first and then you'll have to show credit. And debit will be shown at first. Here, Shyam is the receiver. So, debit the receiver means Shyam's account will be shown in the debit side with rupees 200. And Ram, who is the giver, will be shown in the credit side with rupees 200. I think it's clear for you guys. Now we should proceed to the next account, the impersonal account, which I have already told that this is bifurcated into real and nominal. What does real stand for? Look, in a business, all those things which can be seen, which can be touched, are treated as real things. It's related with cash, goods, assets, etc. Rule for real account is debit what comes in and credit what goes out. Just suppose, I've given an example over here. Bought machinery of rupees 5,000. Look, whenever you are thinking of any transaction, you'll have to just treat yourself as a businessman. Don't think that someone else is doing business. It's your business belongs to you. And all the transaction belongs to you. Think from your points of view. Bought for a machinery of rupees 5,000. Who has bought? You have bought. Treat yourself as a business, a unit. You have bought a machinery. From your points of view, machinery is coming. That's why it will be shown in the debit side. And in this transaction, what's going out? Obviously, cash. Because whenever you are purchasing something, cash will go out to cash. So, debit what comes in and credit what goes out. And last but not the least, that is nominal account. In business, there are so many, innumerable of expenses and income takes place. Nominal account relates with all expenses, income, profit and losses. In debit side, you'll have to show all expenses and losses, and in credit, all income and gains. Let me exemplify. Paid salary of rupees 2,000. Look, whenever you are paying something to run a business, it's very important. You must have knowledge about the expenses, because no one will give you the service in a free mode. You'll have to pay salary, you'll have to pay wages. You'll have to pay honorarium for them. So whatever you are paying, that's an expense for the business and will be treated in the debit side. So salary account is debited, and in this way, you are paying something, means cash is going out, so to cash account. This is how we used to identify these three rules. You'll have to just inculcate in your mind till you are in touch with accountancy, because these are the foundation. You must bear that.